All right, now the corporate travel industry is fighting back against politicians and others who are criticizing business travel as a lavish expense. Suzanne O'Halloran is covering this story for us. And Suzanne, the industry has been vocal about this in the past. What's new about today's proposal?
Well, Matt, AIG and others have taken a lot of heat for planning luxury business trips after taking TARP money. However, in the last few weeks, 20% of companies that haven't received government aid have canceled meetings. Now the industry is asking the government to take action.
Come out with guidelines for corporate meeting incentives. It can be a measurement and a template for what makes good business practices. What we'd like from lawmakers and the Treasury is to adopt those guidelines so we don't have a moving target, so people know what is accepted and what is not accepted and can really speak to the legitimacy of these events.
And travel is a $740 billion industry today. The U.S. Travel Association rolled out a grassroots campaign titled Meetings Mean Business. A full-page ad is featured in today's edition of USA Today. The group also targeted select political websites as well. And Matt, Las Vegas is already hard hit. Laura mentioned this a little bit earlier, but MGM shares fell more than 16% today after the casino company said it may default on some debt. Plus, analysts at KeyBank said shares of Wynn Resorts may fall to the $13 level because of the negative psychology towards business travel and the sluggish economy. Matt?
Hey, isn't the economy the bigger wild card, really, versus criticism of corporate travel here?
Well, the economy may be the bigger issue, Matt, but travel executives say the added negative rhetoric may prolong the economic downturn. Business travel accounts for $240 billion in spending and creates more than 2 million jobs, but not this year. The industry is projecting job losses of about 247,000. Last year, the industry cut nearly 200,000 workers. And, Matt, this will probably be highlighted with Friday's jobs report. The U.S. may have cut another 600,000 jobs, according to economists, pushing the unemployment rate closer to the 8% level. Matt?
All right, Suzanne, thanks very much for that. And you could read all about the stories you hear about here on Bloomberg Television at any time and see lots of cool charts and numbers, too, on our website. Check it out at Bloomberg.com. Now, coming up in the next half hour...